Hello and welcome to Alfons Zeilais. My name is Johanna Nagelsbach. I am the grandniece of the painter Alfons Zeilais. While Alfons Zeilais was studying with Professor Karl von Mahr in 1909, Hugo von Tschudi took up his post as director of the State Galleries. After the conflicts with Emperor William II in Berlin, he had great expectations. Watch this video to find out if these expectations were fulfilled. Hugo von Tschudi would like to enrich the Pinakotheken in Munich with modern foreign art. An extension is planned for the new Pinakothek. Hugo von Tschudi has 100,000 marks a year at his disposal for acquisitions. A commission, of which Hugo von Tschudi is also a member, votes on the acquisition proposals. However, the final approval lies with Prince Regent Luitpold. Hugo von Tschudi tackles the reorganization of the old Pinakothek with great enthusiasm. He is assisted by Heinz Braune, a trained art historian, who will complete this task in Tschudi's spirit after his death. Heinz Braune is also interesting because he was well connected in the Munich art scene and was friends with Hans Pohrmann and Albert Weisgerber. Alfons Zeilais knew Hans Pohrmann and exhibited with him in the Arbeitsgemeinschaft Pfälzer Künstler, the Palatinate Artists Association in the 1920s. Alfons Zeilais will also have noticed how von Tschudi worked in the old Pinakothek. There were major changes, which the newspaper Münchner Neueste Nachrichten reported on page 1 on December 18, 1909. There is the problem with the lighting. It is decidedly too sparse for the large rooms. The penetrating overhead light often appears dead and chalky, and on cloudy days everything is blurred, or at least blurred before your eyes. One of the reasons for this was the often very dark wall coverings. Hugo von Tschudi had these painted where he considered it necessary, which brought an enormous amount of light into the rooms. Old German and Dutch painters were given white walls. The later Dutch kept their dark green, the Flemish and Van Dyck light green. The Spanish and French rooms are given a light grey green, etc., etc. Hugo von Tschudi has many pictures taken to the archive and hangs the remaining ones much more loosely. He also hangs the pictures much lower than before and never more than two on top of each other. Hugo von Tschudi is not only director of the Munich art collections, but director of all Bavarian art collections. He not only redesigns the Munich galleries, he also brings outstanding works that have been removed to Munich and gives other works to the museums from which he retrieves works as replacements. The newspaper Allgemeine Zeitung on December 25th, 1909 writes, "The Bavarian state has more painted canvas than it can use and place in Munich and Schleißheim. That is why it has poured some of its wealth into the provinces. In Augsburg, Würzburg, Aschaffenburg and other cities, the foreigner finds good paintings that the state has lent to the local public collections. These pictures lead a contemplative and quiet life in the provinces. They are rarely disturbed by fiery art enthusiasts and hang in their usual place as befits good pictures." This continued until the spring of 1909, when Privy Councillor von Tschudi became head of the state art collections. The newspapers write about robbery. Augsburg and Nuremberg vehemently defend their paintings. Hugo von Tschudi has to make concessions and, for example, leaves some works in Nuremberg, contrary to his plans. His redesign of the old Pinakothek is finally highly acclaimed. The newspapers report very good attendance at the old Pinakothek, although admission is only free on Wednesdays and Sundays in order to improve the Pinakothek's financial situation. Admission is charged on the other days. This is also the subject of heated debate in the newspapers. It took a year before Hugo von Tschudi again came into conflict. In 1909 and 1910, he still enjoyed a high level of recognition.
Thank you for accompanying Alfons Zeilais in 1909. He must have followed the reorganization of the old Pinacothek on site on the 3 days. In the next video, we will see how Alphonse Zeilis developed in his studies. I look forward to seeing you again.